What's up guys, this is Balázs from SBrick. In today's video I will show you a sneak peek of a very exciting app that gives you the possibility to control several different LEGO and third-party Bluetooth-enabled devices. This is SBrick Pro. Please bear in mind that this is still a beta version. Unfortunately, you cannot try it out right now. There are things that might change until the final release, but we can get a good overview about the functionality, and the team really would like to know your feedback about it, so make sure to watch it until the end and leave your comments below. I don't know when the full version will be released, but make sure to check the official SBrick resources as a public beta access is planned in the near future. Let's start with the big changes. The new app has the same look on the different platforms. This means you can run it on your computer, your phone or your tablet, and you get the full experience everywhere. No need to run anymore the editor on your PC and later download the profile to your smart device. I guess it is still more comfortable to do the coding part on a bigger screen, but you will have the possibility to make adjustments on your smart device as well. Another major development compared to the previous version, the app can control several different devices. It connects obviously to SBrick units, but the support is extended to the powered up City and Technic hubs, Buvis units, the Video 2 hub and the powered up remote as well. This means that you can pretty much control all the recent Bluetooth-enabled hardware that you can possibly use with your remote-controlled creations. Now let's take a closer look at the interface. You need to create an account, and by logging in you will have access to the same profiles on all devices. Here you can see a list of the available devices, you can connect to them and even test the ports. As I saw, there's no point to connect everything here since the configuration will be done elsewhere. This interface is basically good to test the devices and outputs. Creating a project starts in a similar way like in the previous SBrick app, but when you click OK, the interface is pretty different. There are two main tabs. This one can be used to add visual elements. If you click on the plus button, you can see the available items. There are the usual controllers, there are different gauges and labels, and you can also add icons, images and so on. Now let's add a few things and see the next steps. The real magic actually happens on the second tab. This is the backend of the graphical interface where you need to configure things. This might not be the best news for everyone, but SBrick Pro is also based on Visual Code Blocks, just like Powered Up or the new Mindstorms app. It uses Google Blockly and not Scratch, but from the usage perspective it is virtually the same. This approach means that there are several advanced possibilities for coding different events, behaviors and complex models, but it also means that you need to have at least a basic understanding of coding principles to use the app. Currently there's no help section in the beta or tutorials, but as the team confirmed they will prepare information for each block and will also provide examples. To be able to use the different hardware elements you need to set up the virtual ports first under hubs. Here you need to select the device type. It can be a lot of things, motors, smart motors, servo, sensors and so on. In the second column you select the hub, this is when you can connect the devices. In the third column you select the port and you also have the possibility to test the output. If you have a smart hub connected that detects the attached device then it will be listed as well. So here's a little test setup I created with several different devices. We have an SBrick connected with a power function servo, a powered up City hub with a medium motor, a Technic hub with a large motor and a Buvis unit with a medium motor. All of these different devices can be connected simultaneously and they can be controlled from the same interface. This range of devices was only available in Brick Controller 2 previously and here you have the possibility to control them from a touch interface. If I switch to the code view you can see that it is not very complex but still requires some background knowledge to set up. The control works fine on my laptop, but these controllers were more designed for a touch interface. Now I logged into the app on the tablet and I can load the same profile. Connecting all the necessary devices takes some time and possibly a few tries, but they managed to all connect at the end and the profile works exactly the same way as on the computer. Now here's another project I created for the 42109 rally car. By default this car only has two motors for drive and steering, so there are two unused ports left. I attached the powered up light to one of them for the front lights and the color and distance sensor to the other one. This code is a bit more complex than the previous one, but not that difficult to set up. We have two events for the button start and release to turn the light on while the button is pressed. There are two gauges, one will display the motor power, the other one will show the value of the distance sensor. There's a dedicated calibration block for the servo that runs on start, then this block links the horizontal slider to the servo motor. This section is basically responsible to control throttle with the vertical slider, but it has a catch. Once the value from the distance sensor drops below 5, meaning that the car approaches something, then it automatically will drive backwards for a second, then stops and checks again if the route is cleared. If there's no obstacle in front of it, then you can control it again with the slider. So, let's see how it works in practice. It starts with the calibration sequence, which is pretty similar to the Control Plus calibration or the one in the Powered Up app, and then the car can be controlled with the sliders and buttons, and we can see the values from the sensors as well. This code has a similar setup, but this time the car is controlled with the powered up remote and not the sliders. As you see, the range of the distance sensor might not be enough to stop the car before an obstacle at full throttle, but luckily there are other sensors with bigger range in the powered up family that will be supported soon. Oh, and I forgot to mention the best part. Just like in the previous SBrick app, you can also use third-party game controllers for control. This means you can choose between three control methods: touchscreen, LEGO controller, or a third-party controller. This makes the app very universal. There are several other code blocks available in the app. This was just a very brief demonstration. I think this app is a huge step forward to have a single interface to control all of our Bluetooth-enabled LEGO and third-party devices. With the coding abilities, it gives us tons of possibilities, but I have to tell you that I have the same concern like I had with the Powered Up app. Currently, it does not provide an easy solution for novice users. I also share this concern with the developers. They are very open to any suggestions or ideas. One of the possibilities could be to create combined blocks that would enable you to set up, for example, servo control and only set the controller and the motor to be used as a parameter, so you don't have to deal with start blocks, loops, and stuff like that. Another option is to set up ready-made profiles for the recent official LEGO sets that you can use and change according to your needs. The team is also planning to add support of other third-party devices to the app, so the possibilities will grow with time. Please share your ideas in the comments. What features would you like to see in the app? What additional hardware should be supported? Would you prefer some kind of simplified approach or interface? Any feedback is valuable for the team. If you like this video, then please give it a thumbs up. You can also subscribe and tap the notification bell if you don't want to miss my tech reviews and other LEGO RC videos. See you next time, bye bye!